Question number 14. Why are static testing and dynamic testing described as complementary? The question is asking why static testing and dynamic testing should be done together because they complement each other. Answer A. Because they have different aims and differ in the types of defect they find. Of course, static testing finds different types of defects than dynamic testing. But do they have different aim? I guess not. They both should aim at finding defects. So this one is, let's say, 80% wrong to me. Let's move on. Answer B. Because they have different aims but find the same types of defect. That's for sure wrong. They find different types of defects. Answer C. Because they share the aim of identifying defects but differ in the types of defects they find. That one sounds too good. Answer D. Because they share the aim of identifying defects and find the same types of defects. Again, wrong. So the correct answer here is C. Question number 15. Reachable code would best be found using code inspections or code reviews or a coverage tool or a static analysis tool. This is an easy one. A static analysis tool can find unreachable code. It needs a tool to find which parts of the code that will never be executed no matter what data input we try. Code inspections and code reviews could help with that too, but it would be a very difficult job for reviewers to find unreachable code using only reviews. A coverage tool just measures the coverage percentage. So the correct answer is D. Question number 16. Of the following statements about reviews of the specification, which statement is true? The question is looking for the true statement. Answer A. Reviews are a cost-effective early static test on a system. This is true, so this could be our lucky winner. Answer B. Reviews are not generally cost-effective as the meetings are time-consuming and require preparation and follow-up. Wrong. Of course, reviews cost money, but they are cost-effective regarding the time and effort saved from finding the bugs using regular dynamic testing. Answer C. Reviews must be controlled by the author. This is wrong. This is only valid for walkthrough reviews. Answer D. There is no need to prepare for a follow-up on reviews. Again wrong. Preparing and follow-up are parts of the review process. So the correct answer here is A. Thank you.